Check, 1, 2, check. Good morning and welcome to the historic Basilica Cathedral of St. John the Baptist. We welcome all of you present and those joining us through live stream. We pray that you are all in good health. We ask that all present respect the instructions given by our ushers and the guidelines in place to prevent the spread of COVID-19, including using hand sanitizers, maintaining a distance of 2 meters, and wearing face masks at all times within the church. We will not have a collection at this Mass, but there are collection boxes provided for you at the entrance and exit of the church. Your donations pay for the utilities and salaries of the parish. Thank you for supporting our Basilica Parish. Due to Alert Level 3, restrictions of 100 maximum capacity, until further notice, you must register for all weekend Masses. There is now no automatic list of names of regular attendees. There is no need to register for weekday Masses at 9 a.m. Our presider this morning is Archbishop Hunt, and our opening hymn is number 343 in the Catholic Book of Worship, As with Gladness, Men of Old. Please stand. As with gladness, men of old, did the guiding star behold. As with joy they hailed its light, leading onward beaming bright. So most gracious Lord, may we evermore your splendor see. As with joyful steps they sped to that lowly manger bed, there to bend the knee before Christ, whom heaven and earth adore. So may we with hurried pace ever seek your throne of grace. As they offered gifts most rare at that manger crude and bare, so may we this holy day, drawn to you without delay, all our costliest treasures bring, Christ to you, our heavenly King.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Today we celebrate the solemnity of the Epiphany, the manifestation of the Lord to the nations. For those of us who are not of Jewish heritage, this is a special day for us because this is the day when we celebrate how Christ came for all. As we gather together to give God worship and to ask his light to shine upon us, let us pause for a moment to call to mind his goodness and to ask forgiveness for our sins. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You came to set us free from our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Let us pray. O God, who on this day revealed your only begotten Son to the nations by the guidance of a star, grant in your mercy that we, who know you already by faith, may be brought to behold the beauty of your sublime glory through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. For darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the peoples. But the Lord will arise upon you, and his glory will appear over you. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. Lift up your eyes and look around. They all gather together. They come to you. Your sons shall come from far away, and your daughters shall be carried on their nurses' arms. Then you shall see and be radiant. Your heart shall thrill and rejoice, because the abundance of the sea shall be brought to you. The wealth of the nations shall come to you. A multitude of camels shall cover you, the young camels of Midian and Ephah, and all those from Sheba shall come. They shall bring gold and frankincense, and shall proclaim the praise of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Response to Psalm 72, Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. every nation on earth will adore you. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. Give the King your justice, O God, and your righteousness to a king's son. May he judge your people with righteousness and your poor with justice. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. In his days may righteousness flourish and peace abound until the moon is no more. May he have dominion from sea to sea and from the river to the ends of the earth. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. May the kings of Tarshish and the isles render him tribute. May the kings of Sheba and Seba bring gifts. May all kings fall down before him. All nations give him service. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. For he delivers the needy one who calls, the poor and the one who has no helper. He has pity on the weak and the needy, and saves the lives of the needy. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
A reading from the letter from St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, surely you have already heard of the commission of God's grace that was given me for you, and how the mystery was made known to me by revelation. In former generations, this mystery was not made known to humankind, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit. That is, the Gentiles have become fellow heirs, members of the same body, and sharers in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? We observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word, so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road. The Gospel of the Lord. The Feast of the Epiphany always makes me think of the Vicar General from my home diocese of a number of years ago, who on this feast, when he said the prayer at the offertory, got things mixed up. In that prayer you'll hear again today, "Lord, we offer you gifts, not gold, frankincense, and myrrh, but," and then it goes on. And he was a bit of a theater buff, and he sort of proclaimed things. So when he got to this one year, he said, "Lord, we offer you gifts, not gold, Frankenstein, and myrrh." And then he stopped. He went, oh, frankincense, not Frankenstein." He's a good man. And I don't say that just because he was the priest that presided over my parents' wedding. In the first reading today from Isaiah, we hear Isaiah say, "Arise, shine, for your light has come." The light is the light that God gives us, but he's inviting the people to shine forth because that light has shone upon them. And in the second reading today, Paul, speaking to the Ephesians, says how the commission of God's grace that was given to him was for them, that he's shining his light, that he's received the light from God and he's shining it on these people. And in the gospel, we see these wise men from the east who have seen the star and have come to recognize what it means and are following that light, and in their own way are shining forth light on those who are willing to accept it. Herod isn't willing to accept it. But Mary and Joseph, the presence of these men coming and worshiping their son, is something that shines light upon them and is an affirmation and a care. Challenge for us is each of us has received the light of the good news of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And the challenge for us is for us to shine that light in our lives. How are we called to do that? How are we called to give him homage by the way we use the graces and blessings that he gives us? The gifts that the wise men give are symbolic gifts. Gold, meaning worldly wealth. Frankincense, meaning worship and prayers. and myrrh being a salve, something that comforts the sick, something that brings healing. And I think if we look at those three symbolic gifts, they give us a sense of how maybe we are being called to shine our light, to share the gifts of this world with those who have less, to give God worship, to make time for prayer so that we can open ourselves to his light so that it can shine out through us, and to be a salve, to be a healing presence in our world. There are so many people that are hurting in some way, for whom the healing touch, a smile, a willingness to hear them out, to listen to them, means so much. You know, I think at times we may feel that we don't have much to give. And at those times, it's important for us to remember the image of the widow's mite in the gospel, where this woman comes and she only has two small coppers, but Jesus points to her as giving more than any other because she gives her all. It also makes me think of that song that we have at Christmas that I don't think has any historic roots, but the little drummer boy. The song talks about how he has no gift fit to give a king, so he plays for him his drum. He does what he can, and the child in the manger smiles. That we do our best, that we give our widow's mite, whatever that might be, in terms of comfort to others, in terms of worship to God, in terms of sharing our riches, however little or great they may be. That we do those things, we are shining our light. And in a very true way, through doing that, we're giving God praise and thanking him for the gift of his son who came to us on that first Christmas so many years ago, and who, in the image of the worship of the wise men, has been given to all of us, of every race and language and culture. He has come for all of us. We are all his people. And through baptism, we are all his brothers and sisters. God bless you. Let us now stand and together profess our faith in a God of goodness and love using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Jesus has assured us that wherever two or more are gathered in his name, he is present in their midst. Confident of God's presence here among us, we offer to him now our prayers of petition.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and our Archbishop Peter, that they may be blessed in a special way as they continue to shepherd the church through challenging times, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church, that through the celebration of the birth of Jesus, that we may see the face of Christ in others, and mission to them, through our deeds of kindness and compassion, especially for those in need. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our archdiocese, as we journey through the process of renewal and restructuring, that we may face the coming challenges and the changes with hope and courage. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
As we pray and dialogue together in preparation for the Synod of Bishops, we pray for a spirit of openness to the working of the Holy Spirit among us in the discernment process. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Like the Magi, may we seek to find Christ in the ordinary events of our lives and the people we meet each day. And may we always be guided by our faith in Jesus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those burdened by addiction, by financial problems, by grief and sorrow, that they may experience the peace and healing of Christ in the new year, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of the sick, especially any power, for those who are impacted by the ongoing pandemic, and we pray for all medical professionals and caregivers who care for the sick, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have recently died, especially for Alfreda Nash, that they may rest in peace of the risen Jesus, and we pray for all who mourn the death of loved ones. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pause for a moment to bow our heads and offer our own personal intentions. For all of these intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we ask you to hear the prayers that we offer you this morning, both those we have spoken aloud and those that are in our hearts, for they are offered through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our offertory hymn is number 346 in the Catholic Book of Worship, In the Darkness Shines the Splendor.
In the darkness shines the splendor of the Word who took our flesh, welcoming in love's surrender death's dark shadow at his crash. Light of nations veiled in history, born of woman's flesh and blood, calling to the depths of mystery, restless hearts that seek the good.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands.
Look with favor, Lord, we pray, on these gifts of your church, in which we offer now not gold or frankincense or myrrh, but he who by them is proclaimed, sacrificed and received, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as a light for the nations. And when he appeared in our mortal nature, you made us new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts,
are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." A mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Basil, Saint Gregory, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, me your unworthy servant, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
Through baptism we are God's children, and so with confidence we can pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Offer each other a sign of the Lord's peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof,
but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
A prayer for those who are unable to receive Holy Communion at this time. My Jesus, I believe you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you, for you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. To ensure that the reception of Holy Communion takes place in a safe and respectful manner, we ask that you please follow these instructions. Instead of individually replying Amen upon receiving the host, there will be one general attestation of Amen before distribution begins. Please remain standing in your pew until invited forward by an usher. Ensure your face mask is correctly worn before coming forward, and maintain a 2-meter social distance in the communion line. As you approach the front of the line, sanitize your hands before receiving communion. Bow toward the host. In silence, receive the host in your hands. Step aside to consume the host. Return to your pew as directed by the ushers. Those unable to receive Holy Communion in the hand may come forward to receive a blessing.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
communion hymn is The Table of Emmanuel.
As we taste the bread of heaven and the cup of love outpoured, we proclaim your birth, Emmanuel, child of Mary, Christ the Lord. The house of bread rejoices, singing heaven's great refrain. Let us join them in their gloria and give glory to God's name. As we taste the bread of heaven and the cup of love outpoured, we proclaim your birth, Emmanuel, child of Mary, Christ the Lord. On those who walk in darkness, those who dwell in lands of gloom, shines the light of love's eternal flame, Jesus, fruit of Mary's womb. As we taste the bread of heaven and the cup of love outpoured, we proclaim your birth, Emmanuel, child of Mary, Christ the Lord. Behold the Virgin Mother as she casts her loving gaze on the love she bears into the world, singing lullabies of praise. As we taste the bread of heaven and the cup of love outpoured, we proclaim your birth, Emmanuel, child of Mary, Christ the Lord.
Let us pray. Go before us with heavenly light, O Lord, always and everywhere, that we may perceive with clear sight and revere with true affection the mystery in which you have willed us to participate through Christ our Lord. I invite you to join with me in praying the prayer of Pope Francis to Mary for help and protection during the coronavirus pandemic. O Mary, you always shine in our path as a sign of salvation and of hope. We entrust ourselves to you, health of the sick, who at the cross took part in Jesus' pain, keeping your faith firm. You, salvation of your people, know what we need, and we are sure you will provide, so that, as in Cana of Galilee, we may return to joy and to feasting after this time of trial. Help us, Mother of Divine Love, to conform to the will of the Father, and to do as we are told by Jesus, who has taken upon himself our sufferings and carried our sorrows to lead us through the cross to the joy of the resurrection. Amen. Under your protection, we seek refuge, Holy Mother of God. Do not disdain the entreaties of we who are in trial, but deliver us from every danger, O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. There's a special blessing for the Epiphany, and I ask you to respond amen to each of the invocations. May God, who has called you out of the darkness into his wonderful light, pour out in kindness his blessing upon you and make your hearts firm in faith, hope, and charity. Amen.
Amen.
And since in all confidence you follow Christ, who today appeared in the world as a light shining in darkness, may God make you too a light for your brothers and sisters. Amen.
Amen.
And so when your pilgrimage is ended, may you come to him whom the Magi sought as they followed the star, and whom they found with great joy, the light from light, who is Christ the Lord. Amen. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father,
the Son,
and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God. Our missioning hymn is number 344 in the Catholic Book of Worship, The First Noel.